What is happening, everyone? Zach here, and today I'll be showing you a video where I'm going to solve an issue that everyone's having with watchOS 4 beta 1, watchOS 4 beta 2, watchOS beta 5. That's where we are right now. So we're having an issue where we can't set up the Apple Watch. I'll show you two methods, and both methods fail, and I'll show you how to fix that, and that is coming up. Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. Alrighty, so this is the normal page you're greeted with. So what you want to do manual, click the I, press English, and then choose your country so you can scroll or do what I'm doing, and then I'll select your country, and then you just go setting language, and this takes forever. And it keeps on spinning and spinning and spinning and spinning, and literally nothing happens. Alright, so as you can see, it failed here, and the manual method failed, and it just gets stuck here. So you can also force press to reset, but I wouldn't recommend it because it will take forever to reset. Just press back and then back and press again, and then you should be like that. The screen where you set up. So this time what you want to do is bring your iPhone close to the Apple Watch, and you should get this screen. So this is the automatic setup method 2, and just press continue, and then it should automatically just do its thing, and then the code should come up, and as you know, just scan the code. After you scan the code, what happens is it just goes through, you know, oh yeah, it's pretty cool. So set as new, left wrist, and keep on going forward, and then it just says connect to my Apple Watch. This may take a few minutes, so I'm gonna force forward this. So as you can see, it takes forever. I'm force forwarding like 20 times, and then it shows the thing again. It shows the code again, and then just bring in the terms and conditions section, which I'm gonna press agree, and then press agree again, and then see what happens. So you will try this, and you if you're going through this same problem, just showing you right now, is basically what you can do is, well, we'll just wait for this, and I'll show you a fix as well. So, and then you get to this section, it says unpairing Apple Watch. Your iPhone's currently unpairing Apple Watch. This might take a while. Okay, so failed again, and we're left with, what are we gonna do? So what you want to do is force press on Apple Watch, and then make sure you press reset. It says error 3, whatever error it is, reset it, and then this shouldn't take that long. So actually this will take a few minutes, and then I'll show you how to get through these two errors. So you want to go settings, this two methods as well solving this. So some people have sold it for just turning off the iMessage. So I'll just show you. You just go in the Messages app and turn on iMessages. It didn't work for me, and it wouldn't work. I don't think I would recommend this one. So the next method you can do is go there and then go to your iCloud settings and then turn off iCloud completely. So put in your password and turn it off. And this will take a while as well. So it just comes up and just says you want to sign out, and just say yes, sign out, and then this will take a while. It will take you a while. I fast forwarded this like 20 times. So now we're signed out. So now that we're signed out of in the iCloud, so what we can do right now is I'll just check. So it just says I'm not signed in at all, and make sure you're not signed into any other accounts as well. So we'll just check in the bottom. So just go accounts and password, and as you can see, I'm not signing to any accounts. You don't want to sign it in account, so the issue that is causing this is because of the iCloud. So it's causing the Apple Watch not to, I don't know. So what you want to do is bring the phone closer again and set it up again, and this time it will work, because I know it will work, I've tried it. So I'm showing you right now. So what you want to do is scan the code again. So as you scan the code, and you can restore from iCloud, don't do that, because you'll bring iCloud again and it wouldn't work. So you set up as new, and you can restore later on. So left, and then just I'll just for educational purposes, so I'll leave the Apple Watch on the top. And then we're just going to fast forward the hell out of this one as well, because this will take a while. And it says that it is connecting to your Apple Watch. This may take a few minutes. This may take a moment. A moment is like 15 minutes it takes. So again, the only reason that this is occurring with watchOS 4, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, beta 4, beta 5, it's because of the iCloud settings. And there's something wrong with it. And Apple hopefully will fix this. So we won't go through it again. As you can see, it's just... Alright, so you'll bring up to again. We'll be back again at the terms and conditions, and we'll have the code coming on the top as well. Don't know why the code is showing. It should show something else. But this works. So terms and conditions, and what you want to do is agree to the terms and conditions and agree again, and this should... There you go, it just bypassed the problem that we earlier had. It didn't take that long. Before, it took forever to go to this screen, so just say okay and create a passcode. There you go, you have access to your Apple Watch right now. I was just saying this is too easy for people to guess. I just use it and then enter it again. Just use a normal easy password and then continue, and don't install later because you want the installation to be as quick as possible. And then this is the installation page, and I'll just go through it with you while we're at it. So there's a few new, there's a new screen on Apple Watch. It's just showing you, it's actually better because people can look through it and you can see what the Apple Watch is about and what it can do. So, but it's really laggy and it doesn't, you know, show up straight away. It just says tap to select, and then it just says press firmly. So just a few little hints Apple gives you, and then next we've got digital crown and what it does. So digital crown is just press to return, press and hold, so you can do all these little functions with them, and then turn it when you have like a text to it or something. And then the side button, it's actually called the side button. Wow. Press to shut down, of course, or press to show the dock. And then double click to the to Apple Pay, which is really handy. I use it, and press and hold for the medical ID as well. She's cool. And then also, if you got any questions at all, make sure you check it down in the description. Check it down in the comments below, and I will definitely have a look at it. And I'm just gonna fast forward the hell out of this one, because this one will take a while to set up for any Apple Watch. So this is just restoring it. I don't know. That's just connecting it to Apple Watch. And then if you're on lower beta, make sure you set up that as well afterwards. But yeah, I'm just gonna fast forward this. And any questions at all that comes to your head, or any problems you have with iOS 11 or Apple Watch, just comment in the description, and then I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Or for faster ways to get to me, you can easily contact me via Instagram, which is right there on the screen right now. Okay, so now it says that Apple Watch is ready for use, and I went through the setup process, and we are, here we go. So we went through, we had two issues to solve, and signing out of your Apple or iCloud, it solves the problem. So right now I'm connected to Apple Watch, and if you're having this problem, or just share it around this video, because I know a lot of people are having this issue with Apple Watch. So what I'll do is I will make sure I'll share it around as well, because it's important. So as you can see, it's all set up. So that's the video for today, and I hope you all enjoyed it, and make sure you give the thumbs up, and I will see y'all tomorrow. Peace.